Halloween may be over, but we still got some scary shit on the market. Energy drinks. And I will tell you my view on them. Now understand that energy drinks are a $50 billion a year business, and they're one of the most utilized supplements on the market today. But they may be something too scary to intake for yourself. The hard part we have to ask ourselves is, why do we consume these drinks? Well, a lot of times it's because either we've missed meals, or we haven't eaten a whole lot that day, or the right foods, right? Two, our hydration is off, so we're sensing that our energy level is low because our salt or our water's not right. Three, we're trying to mask either inefficient, either in length or quality of sleep. All of which might make us feel better for a very short time with energy drinks while we train, but it's just gonna compound the problem. So when we do these things and we mask our energy levels due to something else being wrong by doing an energy drink before we train, we're not actually fixing the issue. So we need to look at all of our systems and all of our things that we're doing outside the gym and make sure that we're not just putting what I call a Band-Aid on a bullet hole. So we have some concerns linked into the energy drinks. One is we have blood vessel issues. We have blood vessel issue constriction, which has been shown in some cases to cause heart arrhythmias, heart attacks, and strokes. Those don't sound like good ideas to me. Two, sleep disturbances. That's pretty common from overuse of caffeine. Now, how can that be when people drink coffee as well? Well, you gotta remember that sometimes some of these energy drinks have up to 3 times more caffeine than a normal cup of coffee, which, you know, some caffeine can be good for you. But you have elevated levels of caffeine for too long or at the wrong time of the day can cause a massive issue in your recovery ability to sleep. Dehydration, caffeine, and some of those other things at higher levels can cause massive amounts of dehydration, which is going to reduce not only the ability and performance long term of your muscle, but also can cause other health issues as well with kidneys and liver. And the next thing is obesity. Some energy drinks have up to 3 times the amount of sugar that should be allotted in a normal day, in a whole day, in one drink, in one can. So you have to be very careful with these energy drinks. Mostly can that cause obesity, right? But it can also cause long-term insulin issues leading to type 2 diabetes. Now, a lot of these energy drinks are coming out with, you know, sugar-free, but we're not really sure if those artificial sweeteners are actually even better for us than real sugar. And in some cases, they can be more harmful. So you have to be careful. So obesity, dehydration, sleep disturbances, and blood vessel issues, these are all major concerns, especially with anybody that's older or younger, i.e. under the age of 18. And you see a lot of kids utilizing a lot of energy drinks. The trick is, though, is how do we get better? How do we fix this? So the big question is, what do we do instead of having energy drinks? I've never been a big fan of energy drinks. I've never really used them that much. But what I do is, and I think one thing why I've never really needed them, is I eat at time points of the day. I try to eat every 2 to 4 hours. And what's in that meal is a lot of good fats and good proteins, not just carbs, okay? So the big thing is, if you have fats and proteins in your diet every 2 to 4 hours, not only is your energy level is gonna be more sustained, your appetite's also gonna be less. Okay, the next thing that you want to do is make sure your salt intake is optimal and use salt with iodine. A lot of times we trigger off hunger or lack of energy because our hydration is off. And that may not necessarily mean we're not drinking enough water, which sometimes can be the case. A lot of times is we're not getting enough good salt. And the other thing is we try to use salt with iodine because iodine really helps the thyroid, which can be a big cause of long-term energy as well. And the next thing is we try to reduce sugar and refined carbs. Well, if you look at it in that perspective, we're controlling insulin response. We're not having huge spikes and levies of insulin. We're not putting in a ton of blood glucose and then pulling it all out and going through starvation points, which is kind of what energy drinks do anyway. We're trying to reduce that sugar and those refined carbs so that our energy level stays nice and solid all day. But a lot of times the reason I see people drinking energy drinks is because they've missed a meal or they're not snacking correctly on the proper fats. One of the big things about energy drinks and processed foods in general that I think is not hit on enough is the added use of sodium benzoate. Now, if you look on your can or some of your food, processed food, you're going to see sodium benzoate in a lot of places. And it has been deemed safe by the FDA, but I'm not so sure. You start reading on sodium benzoate, it starts to kind of frighten you and what's going on. You look at increased inflammation. Now, anybody that knows anything about health is higher inflammation levels are not a good thing. So if you need to do some research on that. oxidative stress. If you're adding more oxidative stress to the cell is going to age faster and not perform as well. That's across the entire body, therefore probably not a good idea as well. Also, you can have increased sensitivity to allergies with sodium benzoate, which we have a lot of these places coming out with a lot of these pills to, you know, reduce allergies and do this and that. It might be just what you're eating. Eating and drinking a lot of stuff with sodium benzoate in it, it's not a good idea. The other thing is they're starting to link it a little bit with cancers. So I am not a huge fan of using sodium benzoate, and I think really the only way that you can safely prepare your food and drink what you drink and eat what you eat is to probably prepare it yourself these days. So I'm not a huge fan of sodium benzoate, but you don't hear a lot of people talking about it. So you guys see my view on energy drinks and really just processed foods in general. I try to stay away from a lot of things that have sodium benzoate in it. I don't really like a lot of stuff that causes dehydration and inflammation. And you know, the scary thing is that the FDA, although they regulate our food, you start realizing that a lot of this stuff can be very, very toxic. Measuring some of the amount of sodium benzoate that can convert into benzene in some of these drinks have been shown 10 out of 100 of these drinks have the highest level of benzene that's regulated by the FDA in them, and they've actually pulled them off the market. So there definitely is a problem with what's going on in the United States and around the world with this stuff, and I think the energy drinks just compound it. So to fix these things and reiterate it, eat clean, eat regular, and make sure that you're hydrated, and you probably won't need the energy drinks anymore.
It's gonna be fucking hilarious.